ix ne can. Today, I want to talk some more about Comanche women in an unusual context. We're going to talk about a language book. Comanche language, book and CD, volume 1, by Comanche tribal speaker Ruth Pahcheka, pick up, granddaughter of, if you can see that, Madishe. I'm really not sure of the pronunciation of her name, but there's a picture of her as well. To my ears, which are not highly trained in Comanche, but I heard my mother speak. I've heard it. I'm not trained in it, and I don't speak it. But this sounds right to me. I hear different people speak. This sounds like, to my ears, it sounds like what I have heard in my own family. So anyway, the interesting thing here is this is in separate lessons. There's 10 lessons, and the woman speaks, Ruth speaks, and first in English, a simple sentence, and then in Comanche. So you learn basically by memory. That's the way it's set out, by rote. But what I'd like to point out is the fact that 95% of this conversation, or these sentences, or these words, are between a woman of any age and children. I don't think any of this is planned. I don't think it's a feminist plot, but it's about a woman and children. It's written from a woman's point of view, and it's just the practical circumstances of life. It is normal for a woman to speak these subjects in this way. But I'm reading into it just a little bit more, that there's so very little about the male, and not very much about boy. It's the woman's friends, her lady friends, her relatives. It's mostly female. And I think that reflects the old days. I haven't taken a statistical evaluation of the Comanche language. Somebody should do that, but it might reveal that most of the conversation is family oriented, and it's going to be about that is what Comanche is left today is the practical Comanche that is between female and children, mother, grandmother, and children. It's very possible that that's the truth. Just listen to a little bit of this. How are you? I am not well. I'm not up to par. I feel fine. This is a dog. This is a cat. Some very simple things here. But before you get very far, what is your mother's name? And it does ask what your father's name is. That's one of the rare places where the male is part of the conversation. Where do you live? I love you. I am hungry. What shall we eat? Where is the salt? Very simple sentences. Are you cold? Do you want some watermelon? Did you fall? Leave it alone. No, I want it. Very, very basic things there. It gets more complicated as you press on. But it's all female-oriented. And it's, I think it's interesting that this approach, natural as it is, I mean, after all, it's a woman that's making this these simple lessons in Comanche. First of all, she did it. You know, I don't know how many men have done this, any of our Comanche speakers. There are men that speak it, elders. But the ones that have made the most effort, as far as I can tell, to communicate the language to the next generation have been our women. There was Geneva Navarro, who I saw her receive a Oklahoma State Award out at the Capitol. I was there. I saw it was a beautiful eagle, sculptured eagle that was given to her. She moved to New Mexico. That's where the elite Comanches go, you know. I'm only kidding. But I think of the speakers that come to my mind. They're women. They're elder women. And I think that's interesting in itself. The Comanche Language Committee, all of our official funded efforts have mostly been women. And what did we say in our first tape on women was that the dominant role played in the camp, in the settlement, in the home. Ik se nuk kan. This is my home. This is my house. This is my place. That's an older, I believe, an older term. A kanik is another term, but I think that one was later. Kan is the original. Nemanu kan, a household, a family, a clan, used to refer to the members, the actual members. Nemanu kan. So even today, in our modern language preservation efforts, the Comanche woman is dominant, and that which is spoken of and spoken about refers to the responsibilities and circumstances of the Comanche woman. I don't think there's any harm in pointing this out or interpreting it this way. I think it's very interesting, and I would suggest for those that are able, knowledgeable. I know language. I know how language works. It's just I wasn't raised speaking Comanche. I wasn't around it much at all. But for those that are able, look into a way of examining the language and see how female-oriented it is. I think that'd be very curious to look into. We'll talk more about this in the future.